everybody. This is The Daily Left on Go Left TV, and I'm Lee Morris. Thanks for tuning in. As you can tell from the headlines, Barack Obama's transition team has hit the ground running, and the most recent decision made seems to show that Obama was serious about his promise to rework the American healthcare system. Obama has asked former Senator Tom Daschle to be Secretary of Health and Human Services. Obama campaigned on the idea that access to health care should be expanded and that all children should be covered. And like Obama, Daschle has been a longstanding proponent of the idea that the federal government should play a more aggressive role in extending health insurance to more Americans and improving the quality of health care. Now, Daschle's got plenty of experience under his belt, having represented South Dakota in the House and Senate for 26 years, including the 10 years he served as a Democratic leader in the Senate, which is likely to prove valuable when dealing with such an explosive issue. He's been pushing health care reform for the majority of those years he served, and today remains a vocal advocate for bringing the roughly 46 million uninsured Americans into the health care system, although he's no longer pushing for the creation of a single-payer system like the one he helped promote during the Clinton years. Now, what would the news be without a story about the lovely and talented Sarah Palin? Well, as Governor Palin begrudgingly settles back into her old job as Alaska's chief executive, a new ethics complaint was filed this week saying she's already improperly mixing her official duties and her broader political ambitions. The complaint charges that Palin broke state ethics rules by holding national television interviews about her run for vice president from the governor's office. Wasilla resident Zane Henning said he filed the complaint with the attorney general. He says Palin is promoting her future political career on state property and points specifically to Palin's November 10th interview with Fox News host Greta Van Susteren. Henning commented on the complaint, saying, "The governor is using her official position and office in an attempt to repair her damaged political image on the national scene." Alaska Executive Branch ethics rules state that officials cannot use state resources to help or hurt a political candidate or a potential candidate. That means no fundraising phone calls on the state dime, no printing political flyers on government copiers, and perhaps no interviews with national news programs from the governor's office. I think maybe we were simply expecting too much from Palin by asking her to duck graciously and gracefully out of the spotlight when her time ran out. We should have known that anyone who loves the spotlight enough to compete in beauty pageants back in her prime wasn't going to give up the attention without a fight. That'd be like asking Paris Hilton to step out of the limelight. Not gonna happen. And finally, in furthering his attempts to screw up everything before he leaves office, President Bush is set to relax the rules protecting certain species of animals and plants. Animals and plants in danger of becoming extinct could lose the protection of government experts who ensure that dams, highways, and other projects don't pose a threat under a regulation the Bush administration is set to put in place before President-elect Barack Obama can reverse them. The rules have to be published by Friday to take effect before Obama is sworn in. Otherwise, he can undo the dirty work with a simple stroke of a pen. Now, while current regulations require wildlife biologists to sign off, the changes would eliminate the input of federal wildlife scientists in some endangered species cases, allowing the federal agency in charge of building, authorizing, or funding a project to determine for itself if a project is likely to harm endangered wildlife and plants. The new rules would also bar federal agencies from assessing emissions of the gases blamed for global warming on species and habitats. But really, who better to determine whether or not a project should move forward than the people who've already decided the project should move forward? Why would you want to mess up the whole flow of things with some dumb vetting process, really? That's all for the Daily Left for today. Before I go, I'm going to draw the name of our winner of today's t-shirt. And the winner is user Abe Danger, A-B-E-D-A-N-G-E-R. Congratulations. We're going to have another drawing tomorrow, so if you post a comment on today's news, you'll be eligible to win a Go Left TV t-shirt. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/GoLeftTV. For all of us here at Go Left, I'm Lee Morris. Thanks for watching Go Left TV, Citizens Media on the Rise.